international governance feature, both Mexico and India, we are non-permanent members of the Security Council as we speak.
Correct.
What is Mexico's agenda on the world stage when it comes to this position?
Well, this is very good. Let me say that, first of all, that we're working closely with India in this regard. We have been consulting with our Indian friends since before we entered the Security Council as non-permanent members, and we're still working together with them on a number of issues. There's a, you know, I mean, you know, sometimes I know it sounds very like anything new or anything, you know, groundbreaking to say that some of the things that we're working on is issues of peace and stability and guaranteeing this kind of things. And as I said, you know, they sound like, oh, you know, this is what everybody's been saying for the past few decades, but it's still equally valid today. A few issues that are different is how we're focusing on that. For example, we're focusing on the question of gender quite a bit. The role that women can play in creating situations of stability and peace in areas where there has been conflict. We're focusing on the fate of children or minors in conflicted situations, which is, again, something that is very, very important and very critical. We're focusing on the issue of arms transfers, and we're not talking necessarily of, you know, large weapons or nuclear weapons, even though that is certainly important, but also small weapons, because this is something certainly in the case of Mexico that has created, that has devastating consequences, and we're trying to get the world community to focus more on this, on this issue, and how this market for small arms is also a destabilizing influence and a source of conflict in many countries. We're also working on issues, you know, I mean, certainly we're supportive of questions like, you know, that India is very, very vocal about, like questions of terrorism, for example. In a broad sense of an approach to, you know, combat terrorism and fight something that of course is so alien to anyone of us. So these are some in very general terms some of the issues that we're dealing with. We had a recently Mexico. Held at the Mexican Initiative, we held a session having to do with under the what is called the ARIA formula in the Security Council on the question of how to create situations of stability and in conflict situations, and it was very well received, and was there was quite a very good feedback that we got from that. Some of these issues, even though they may be old in the agenda, that does not mean that they're not equally valid today. So we really need to keep focusing on that, as well as, of course, being forward-looking and to see how we can move ahead to create conditions of stability and peace around the world. After all, that's the mandate of the Security Council. It's there's other organs of the UN that can do many other things, and they do, some of them do very well. We've also worked, we've talked in the Security Council on the question of the fair distribution of the vaccines, which is, coming back to an issue that we started with, because we also feel that if you don't do that, you're creating, a gap around the world, and that this can also have destabilizing consequences. And therefore, we need to be aware that something that, maybe not too many people are thinking about, but that the equitable distribution of vaccines around the world and within the countries around the world is very, very important for world stability.
Well, Your Excellency, we'd like to thank you for being very candid with us. We'd like to give you the last couple of minutes, give you the floor. if there's anything you would like to discuss, any message for any Indian audience?
Well, you know, the only thing that I would say is that, you know, we're very happy with the way that the relationship with India is moving ahead. We have had since 2016 a privileged relationship, what's called a privileged relationship between Mexico and India, and we're working towards the establishment of a strategic relationship in the foreseeable future. But more than, you know, going beyond titles, one of the things that we're trying to do is to have a closer, a deeper, and broader relationship with India across the board. We've had, we've talked a little bit about trade and some of the issues on the international agenda, but we're also, you know, trying to focus a lot on cultural aspects, on people-to-people contact. We're trying to increase tourism flows between, you know, Mexico and India. We're trying to increase the academic cooperation. We're trying to work together on issues of innovation and, you know, technological advances, of which India, of course, is doing fantastic things. So, the agenda is very broad, and we certainly think that a country like India and a country like Mexico, which are regional powers in their own right, and of course also have a global perspective, can work together and work closer in the future for the benefit of our respected people, but also for the benefit of the international agenda. So this is, I think, not necessarily a message, but this is more or less, you know, what I wanted to convey to the Indian audience, that this is where we are, and we hope that we'll be able to have the full cooperation of our Indian friends in achieving this goal.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much.
This is an absolute pleasure.
Thank you.